This is One Pot Show with Triple A on Sierra Network Radio.
This is Fanta Series, the One Pot Show with Triple A. Get at the pandemic, make we all can pull the One Pot on Sierra Network Radio with Triple A.
Sierra Network Radio, all day, every day.
Buna Trot. Sierra Network Radio, Triple A, present the One Pot Show. Maggie Pepper Salt, the number one, auto 2, 3, or 4. Make the moon cool, the moko. Left Kalo Kalo, Kegis World Go. One Pot Show, Bonatrot, make it Allah. Oh, oh. Yeah.
Sierra Network Radio, all day, every day.
One with a faith that wisdom inspires.
One with the faith that wisdom inspires.
That never
the zeal that never gets tired.
Ever we see to honor thy day.
We go ever live for honor the name of Mama Salon. Yes, now so we go start we program proper for today. And as I be tell we earlier on, we get a very good topic. And with me inside the topic today for help me for push the program, I get Bolo Spencer Coca all the way from United Kingdom. Welcome to Sierra Network once more, Bolo Spencer Coca.
Thank you very much, Triple A. And as always, my big pleasure for day on your radio show again. So thank you again for the opportunity.
You're welcome on board, sir. And today we topic for the day, a very interesting one. Today we talk about if somebody gets an opportunity for change something in a salon. There's a lot of things that people are going to say, oh yeah, we need this change. It's like we just need for do a 360 of Sierra Leone and we start all over again. But if we get opportunity for change one thing, what's in that thing and why not the reason we'll feel safe for change them? We don't put this online because this particular question be inspired by the BBC Media Action Group na Salon, where they don't host the show na Salon. So we just think, say, we safe can do am nayana the diaspora. And we don't get a lot of text, we don't come inside. During the show, I got to chip in with the text them and everything. But I want to hand over the baton to you now, Bolo, and make you help we for understand this particular topic.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. Obviously, you don't do a brief introduction of the topic itself. But really, within the topic they look at now, how we will bring development to Sierra Leone. You know, when we talk about how we will bring change, you get good change and bad change. So we say we really want to focus on this program. Now positive change, so we will bring development, and we use development for capture so many different things. Also just money, also include personal development, how people that they develop. So now that's part of the program. How we will bring about positive change and basically asking the people that now each individual we get salon at heart for say waiting in go change and why. You understand? So it's a two-part discussion. The topic is the one for discussion. It's like two parts. The first part now, waiting you go change. So talk say some people say, okay, oh I go like for see education change. Which you go change by education, not for just say I want to see and change
yeah,
it.
Definitely.
And give me the utopia vision. Like, okay, yeah, I go like, you know, I go like for saying so. No. The question was specific than that. You want to hone in on, okay, if you don't see the area where you will see the one biggest change which will impact the majority of Sierra Leoneans, yeah? If you think in education, we're waiting you go change. Now that's, you know? And then why? Why not that thing that you will change? So really we want to focus on that. So I want everybody to understand that aspect of the discussion and try to focus on. For the hour or whatever we will be on the air, on which you will change and why.
Yeah, definitely. That's true, though. Because off-air, I mean, they get conversation with certain people, them. So I ask them, just like how you talk just now. Then they begin bring every kind of this reason, that reason. And I was like, no. The question is simple. Waiting and why? So I begin breaking down for like a particular people, them. And they were like, oh, okay. Because when you the question is kind of broad, and I glad the way you don't try for narrow, I'm done for we, so that we go definitely try for get an understanding. And I want make we just like how I say the people they don't send different text them, and based on that, I think say I just want maybe like go ahead and begin read one or two texts and we then send them. I don't know if we can discuss it or how you think, say, we forgot about everything now.
Well, I think for the benefit of we listeners, them, they don't get the first part introduction. So I think the best thing for I do right now, for give an example of, say, for example, waiting me go change. Let me try to answer the question first.
Yes.
Before we even just ask people them and listen to people them. Let we try for answer the question first. And let me try to put forward an answer of waiting me go like for change like Sierra Leone and why. Then it will maybe guide some of the text and we get also get for coming during the program, because as you see people that listen now and people that get very animated. Tell you they say myself been talk to some of me friends and colleagues then before the program just for gauge waiting people and go like for change. So I know say you get a lot of diverse views and people are very, very emotive and very emotional. They get very, very strong opinions about waiting and go like for change. So let me give an example. For me, waiting and go like for see change in a Sierra Leone is this. I go like for let we change the way we treat we unemployed people, the people that will not get job. Me go like for change the way we treat them. Okay, so before they say how I go like for change the way, like I get an idea of how then they treat me right now. Okay, so what do we don't get job that second you right now, for all intents and purposes, it kind of left on your own for strive for same job. Okay, so the way the government they treat them, the government they treat them like they're not important anyway, right? That are the system we get. I know they blame APC government or whatever. This now from time immemorial, yeah. Successive government don't kind of treat people that will not get job this way. So we go like for let we change that. That's Sierra Leone. The way I go like for let we change that now by introducing like close a nationwide center name, who's I people that were unemployed go and go declare their status. Right, so I go like for change that. Right now, we're not getting away like that, so we go like for change that system. And get a system whereby when somebody not get a job, it gets on site in a local area. Abroad, maybe they will call a job center. Recently, job center appear now with budgets by Sierra Leone. So we go like for seeing that, let like, because we get a nationwide system, so people, no matter outside in the on site accessible, wouldn't they able to go and go register themselves and say, hey, I don't get job, I'm willing and able for work, I look for job, and then kind of thing. A central system. Now that me go like for change, let's say. The second part of the question are why I go like for change that one? Well, the reason why I go like for change that one, then boku, okay, the specific reason, but the first one, we always, they go on about solving poverty. Well, I say we, I mean the world collectively. We get organizations like the World Bank, IMF, United Nations, African Development Bank. All these organizations, they spend billions upon billions of pounds, dollars, whatever in currency for try to fix this poverty situation. Well, the reason you go like what they do in a country like Sierra Leone and begin to register these unemployed people, are they guarantee you say the people that they work now, World Bank, IMF, all inside, and they all the world now, the world renowned economists, then they all know say you not be able to solve a problem where you're not able for quantify. That even across discipline kind of knowledge. Even engineer will tell you that one day. That nurse na hospital will tell you that one day. So then they go across. If you're not able for quantify, meaning if you don't know how many people unemployed, you're not able for solve that problem. It's just impossible. So that is one of the primary reasons why I go like for let we change that day. For let we able position we country, not just say you but we focus on that one day we own country. For let we position we country in a space where we the able for actually minimum where we say we want for solve this poverty problem. That are one of the most important things. Now the other reason them and the why. If people then go register now, they say they're unemployed. The first thing we don't do, obviously, I don't highlight. We go before country, they will not say, okay, now 2 million people unemployed. The second thing we're able to do with them people and do within the camp for can't declare their status is we're able to profile them. You understand? Profiling, I mean, if you look at two different categories, we're able to look at them by look at the history, which they don't learn, which they don't learn, whose skills they get, whose skills they don't get, whose education they get, all in kind of things, whose interest they get. Whose access to finance they get, whose access to finance they don't get. Or we look at them, then we will put them into at least two categories. Right? Remember I say now we try to get people them gainfully employed. So we either put them into a category where they get enough resources, human resources, financial, all that one day for create a business, a small business, maybe it might be a home business or something, or community-based business. Or we able to categorize them as people then wait, they want to have job skills and get so they try to offend them jobs. Because don't forget, when somebody sets up a business, it creates at least 2-3 jobs. So with that kind of system, me feel say a country like Sierra Leone go finally get a chance, an opportunity for getting itself out of poverty. Because waiting happen now, the way they treat people we unemployed right now. He know they lead to development of the country. And right now, remember, say the question, we decide whether you want to change something. Remember, say you answer, you get for B in relation to positive change, right? So we say change is not just negative change, positive change, and lead to national development. So me, you are for change the way they treat we unemployed people and right now because the way they treat them right now, you know, they lead to, you know, they aid the national development. It is drain resources from national development. So I want change that one day. I want to change that. This is not something we mining or this or that, anything else or that, any of that. Thing. I just, me focus on just human resources, the way they treat them people. And it's a system whereby they go for good declare themselves. So that's kind of me own example and kind of what me they look for from the listeners in relation to the text, the calls or whatever, as to how they want for change, within they go like for change in Sierra Leone, and why. So I go stop it for now. Maybe we can look at some of the text there now, or maybe you will give your own view assessment on within this example where I don't give. Maybe later we discuss how far then they can go if we actually implement something like that. How far might that go? So over to you, sir.
Yes, exactly. When you talk, it just give me an opportunity for just broaden the unemployment side way you come with. And one thing we, I think, say we need in Sierra Leone, I think we've been on the talking before on previous shows then, na database. And you make a very vivid point about if you want to solve a problem, you need to know the problem, you need to know the intensity of the problem. And to me, when you're talking, I just see like, say, there's a stigmatization about unemployed people. If one, then go say no to rare boy. Two, then go say maybe na rare girl. Or three, you understand? These are the categories where they put people that will not work. Even in the way where then they try for GoFundMe and all them things, then they, it's really sad when you open up and see the reality of things. And I just want to bring something inside now when we talk about unemployment. And I know say you, in a few days ago, you'll be this alone. So that's why I'm very happy to have you on board. So you go able for throw more lights for we. when we are talking about agenda for prosperity, and now we talk on employment, having a database, how you go collide them two then together?
Well, basically, for me, if we talk about agenda for prosperity, you get for, in the NBA National Development, you get for look at waiting you get where you're able for use for help you achieve national development. The biggest thing we Sierra Leone gets, whether we realize it or not, now we people there, right? These 6 million or whatever people that we talk about, now them, now we strongest resource we will get. So before we spend, imagine, waiting the amount of money, forget about the brain and force we don't put into things like mining and anything. Imagine the amount of money we don't go into mining. If half of that money they be don't go into a national job center system, so at the same time they explore your mining thing. Imagine if you don't create a system with half of that money or quarter of that money, where you get a national system where people do register themselves. And like you say, that center they go get computer systems where then they use for collective data. So then go before they share this data around the country to these development organizations and all that kind of stuff. Then they, you know, so the way they said they make them plan as to how they solve the unemployment problem. And then they make them decisions based on actual figures. They don't make them based on the guesstimates the way they use right now. Because all UND do right now is the guess. They use certain kind of formula, pay economics, then big money. Then they guess within the number of people that were unemployed based on all kinds of things. They might be accurate, they might not. But they cannot be as accurate as actually trying to get a real count, and a real count with the update on a daily basis in real time. So if you talk about agenda for prosperity, who are this prosperity for? Who do you want for actually prosper? Now the people them you want for prosper. When you talk about the country Sierra Leone, you're actually encompassing in that one word, Sierra Leone, or the two words, yeah? They encompass the people. It is the people that make up Sierra Leone. You talk about the Mende man, you talk about the Timini man, you talk about the Limba man, the Creole man, the Lokop man, you talk about all these people, the Fula man, the Liban. You talk about all these people. We talk about agenda for prosperity. Well, in my own book anyway, okay? Because I don't really want to get into politics. This is about politics. This is national development. So when you truly are talking about an agenda for prosperity, now that you're supposed to talk about. You're supposed to talk about something, the way they develop the one whole nation. And if you not include the people there, if you know what they talk about include, I mean engage, not for just the telling word or just the pass information to them, do this. When I mean you get an opportunity, well, let them self come to you and tell you, say, hey, sir, I'm unemployed, I don't get a job. But however, I get this skill, mean a painter, yeah? Me, dama with next to me, in a mason. The other one don't yanda in a electrician. The other one yanda in a plumber. So okay, fine. Get them together. Give them small business advice. 6-7 weeks training. How then go form a small company where they focus on servicing the community. Do you understand? So that person will say we want below. So you get local people away just to go call. You know, people will begin to go far and wide. We go far and wide, there are other impacts. Think about it. If you're below na free tongue, you have to go find the best electrician na Kenema. Anytime they come up to you, you get for the drive up and down, petrol, cost, damage to the environment, damage to the vehicle, all of that kind of stuff, and they add to the cost. And then it's really add to the cost of getting the same thing done. They hinder national development in Iowa. Do you understand? It's like corruption. If they give you 100 million for do something, you only spend 60 million on them. You they hinder. You might still do development with the 60 million we put towards the road or the hospital or the buses or whatever. But that 40 million where you owe, you they hinder development in some way. Do you understand? So it's the same thing. When you disenfranchise a whole, I know we give you number now, because if me say give you number of waiting and disenfranchised in relation to unemployed people in Sierra Leone, I go be just like the UN, just like the IMF, just like the World Bank, just like all of them people, and they will just guess. Because I don't know. But here's the funny thing. Yeah? People, you live in America. Right now, I don't spend a lot of time in the UK. A lot of people, they listen and they abroad. They know that in England and America, presidents, they lost election based on employment figures. Am I lying?
No, you're definitely right.
The UK Prime Minister, if unemployment figures reach a certain number, it lost in job. In fact, you know, if you need to go election, in your own people, in your own MP, in your own party, then go vote no confidence in that if unemployment figures begin to a certain amount. So when they talk about national development now, and national development, we know say we depend on we international partners right now because of the precarious situation we would deal with. So when you talk about national development, I know this also, let me say, this is to APC, SNPP, whatever business, I really know. This involves the World Bank, the UN, the DFID, all of them. All of them no want for lay we get development in our country. So the battle is so huge that we get for change now one day. Now, if you're the Prime Minister of Britain and you know say you your job rely on unemployment figures, why if you go to Africa, a country like Sierra Leone, you decide to go put money for national development? If you want for put you aid the way you give, if you have for put terms to that aid like they did, let me give an example of what the British government did recently. The British government go for give money to Sierra Leone and Nigeria and other African countries, and the stipulation where they put for giving that money was that they for accept gay rights. Now, me, you know, they say I get issues with gays or I don't get issues with gays. No, our friends who are gays. Not so many issue that one. Not so many issue that one. My issue is if the British government get that power, they for put stipulations on aid where they give it, and then they recognize the value of unemployment figure because they don't say they can lose their job on that. Why do not ever go to Africa and say this aid where they give you, the stipulation is that you for create a center where they count the number of unemployed people where you get in our country. Because in a million country England or a million country America, I don't know to say they make a huge difference. Why they don't do that? So this kind of change, for that kind of change happen for national development, you get to understand the other wide factors with the impact on national development. Sometimes we rush, we quick to blame our government, say they're able to do this, they're able to do that, whatever. But then, if the people are willing to give them more money than they actually raise maybe in taxes from their own country, if people are willing to give them this kind of money, not giving the right guidance and not put the right stipulations and conditions on the business affairs or the intergovernmental affairs within the transact, we are in trouble. We are in big trouble. So what you mean they have to do right now is to get people to just think wider. Just think wider. Think when they look at the problem, look at them holistically. The impact of something like this, having a center where people can go and register themselves unemployed, the impact we get on Sierra Leone, one, it's going to be immediate, and two, it affects the whole country simultaneously. That's how you get national development. National development does not come by me, I am a party from this particular area, so when I cannot power, vote for me because we come in that area, they will boku, we come in that area, they vote for me, that they will fix your area. That is not national development. That is regional development. If we want national development, we have to come up with schemes, really embrace and engage everybody, all man. So I hope that the conversation and the text then will come in that vein day, you know, as opposed to the generic, well, I'm going to like foresee education change. I want to pull the minister. Come on. You know, we need to think deeper than that now. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, definitely.
It's not about personalities, because unless you can show we say, if I change one person, the impact is going to be national, then you don't need to suggest that kind of idea within this program. You know?
Okay.
So I'll stop it for now. Hopefully, we don't kind of profile everything. We don't give people any rich understanding. We can dissect that a little bit further. I'm ready for taking any questions you get, because I don't see you question any amount of. So I go pause there and listen to the question that you get.
Okay. And Fambulem, with the listen, Yusuf gets opportunity for call, not the program. And Agladi, I get Bolo, maybe down the road, we go get Yusuf. We go join we alongside. And you get the opportunity for call. Break down. We don't break and down for now. So we take the ride. Not forget to say the number, the country code now one. And anyhow, you can dial international number, but the country code now one, if not 001. Yes, but the number now 646-610-3107. The number again now 646-610-3107. You can call and make your voice known. If you get opportunity for change something in a salon, waiting at the one thing and why, waiting at the reason. And just like how Bolo don't enlighten, we not come for talk about government, change government. No, that's not why we're here. We there for talk about the positive things we you want for see happen in a salon. And inside this first part, we did talk about unemployment. We did talk about having an unemployment center, having a database for make we able for know how many people are unemployed in a salon. Then they go be in positive change, because based on those figures, just like how then they do overseas, based on those figures, then we can able for see prospect down the road where somebody they come for can help you. I not go send you go market. I not give you list of what I want. I say just go market, market big. You know, you go buy everything. Okay. Way. I don't know, but and it's rather. Let me just get a conversation going. And I still want to stick to this unemployment area because it looks very interesting. Okay. Yeah, we don't talk small about having a database. We talk about the people the way they come for can help we. We no one enlighten we say, I give you this money, but I need for know who that they go help. I give you this, but I need for know who that them na the people that we really get for benefit out of this. What you find out in helping out Sierra Leone, we get a blanket way of helping. We okay, now we let me take the slum community. They don't give them 3 months notice everybody for move commodity. Mm-hmm. All the slum area then where they say prone to disaster areas then. So when the thing be happen, the flood be happen 2015, remember say them be pull and they carry them go stadium. From stadium, then carry them go Usaeva, then carry them go now Wataloya under Fire Mambo, then build places then. But not to everybody be goody. And we began to find out along the line, say some people them we now when then the shape for it, 10 for each stadium they full. Or all the places then Atuga stadium they full. Everywhere where they did full. Mm-hmm. But when Nets come, the place they empty. Now just few people and they sleep there. And then get for find out, see, at the end of the day, most people return back to those areas. When are they listening to 98.1, because we can do streaming every morning, there is one particular person waiting, he say, Nakubi. He say, make the government not pull and come on at the slum community. Make it not pull and come out there. But rather, make it pull the slum come out pandem. So in that particular area of thinking, and now we talk about positive change, now they are bringing you come inside Bolo. Waiting are your thoughts on that?
Well, the man within the slum, I understand why he is saying Andy. It is saying Andy because it probably, you know, don't see another reality way more appealing. Do you understand? If you look at so many different factors, if you look at the fact that that area there, you don't have people in there, so that area there, they do business, so say the business way they do kind of situated around that area there. Do you understand? So it kind of, in whole livelihood sort of built around the slum. And nobody know how for left Usa in livelihood today. We know about what they call economic migrants, people the way they move. Like the Lebanese in Sierra Leone, they're there because of the opportunity to make money. So that kind of economic migrant is like, you know, I left Sierra Leone. Do you understand? Irrespective, Sierra Leone not perfect. Sierra Leone not get perfect wood. Sierra Leone not get light. Sierra Leone, you understand? Sierra Leone not get all these things.
Yeah,
it
definitely.
Is like the slum. The slum not get all these things. But do you see the Lebanese wanting to leave Sierra Leone? No, they don't. It's for the same reason, but on a lower level, in relation to financial reward, is why that man in the slum, no one left the slum. So let me understand now and the force. Once we understand that, we understand now, see, if only you pull that man at the slum, you get to actually put before a better opportunity. Let me use the example of the Lebanese in Sierra Leone again. The only way a Lebanese will leave Sierra Leone now, if he can go to another country, doing the same thing that he's doing, enjoying the similar kind of life, you know, the freedom, police, this, that, whatever, all them kind of freedom in another country, so it's not just about the money, but enjoying all those kind of freedoms, all the freedoms that they're doing, and even with the challenges, if he did all the same thing and they enjoy the same thing and make more money, You understand? That's the only reason that man will say, okay, yeah, well, they go up to Uber and that because it's, well, they salary make 1 million. But if I go to Nigeria, they do the same thing and they make 10 million doing the same thing because they pay more for the same thing. So it might move. Do you understand? That guy in the slum, you have to do the same thing. The problem with giving that slum man what he wants is it's just not feasible because in a way, it would hold back national development. What do I mean by that? Remember, we don't talk, say, if you they stop money, we can go for other thing, right? Can go for something we not necessary, double spending kind of thing. Then you hold back national development. So let's think logically. If government today say we want to remove the slum and the people within the slum, then get two choices. The one choice, and for build around them, right? So I mean build, I mean come in, do the survey, know what you need for do. So then that survey they include geological survey for drill, for see how far the earth be, how far it go under, because like base cool based on a swamp land. So you need for do that kind of survey for know whose kind of load they will take in relation to structure. Based on that report today, now you decide now, say, well, I will put 1 story in or 2 story or 20 story skyscraper or whatever. You will now get for country people that are waiting at Kube for see if this new thing will be built, if you go accommodate the oil, because if you don't get for accommodate the oil, then problem get for come later, because some man will not get time for go and they revolt and all that kind of stuff. Then. So for do all that one day with the people that are waiting at the slum inside of it, it just go either impractical, meaning it's not possible for do, or it costs more. Because you know, go who say you for clear, you know, clear, you restricted to the land where you will drill big old pan. Because you get for remember now, say if I can't drill all next to this person, it might collapse. All those kinds of things, so it will cost more. The other option is, yeah, remembering you want for remove the slump memo. The other option is you move them, they go put the other side first, yeah, then you can out, you do all which you need for do, you decide which you decide for build, blah blah blah, blah. Then you build, then you move them, come back in. Then they back a double cost. Because once you remove them and all that kind of stuff, the other side you have to go put there, you have to pay for that one. Yeah? So, if you want to do national development, for me, if I want to look at another thing that I would change in Sierra Leone is instead of building roads first, right, I would build houses first.
Okay.
Two reasons. One, I did not able to go meet up in a bay and go put in a new community. So, I go develop communities. We get a lot of free land in Sierra Leone. You know, and as government, you can build anywhere you want. So you can build Fritong, Bo, Kenema, blah, 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 encourage people to even go back to the communities. Because a lot of people will relocate to Freetown during the war and they not see great opportunities for go back, you know, accommodation being one of them, opportunities for work, all that kind of thing. Anyway. So, but some man say if they Kamakwe, he's able to go to a job center, cannot get a job for go register. And he believes that system will actually help him for either get a job or build business. Then he's more willing to relocate back to his own local community anyway. You know what I mean? So, in relation to where you look at now, in relation to national development, the reason I go say you do housing is because, one, the people that when they move into the houses, right, where they build in that other area, now from the slum direct to their homes, then they, a permanent move. So it's a one-time move. That's it. If you don't build your church day, and your school day, those will just build also. Build one church, they build one school, they build them for anything, and they look at amenities. So when people move in, now, once you don't build that community, you can begin focus on road. What you do? Because now you get us. They build and they pay their rent. You don't create a job for rent officer, how they go collect rent or your system or whatever. You get a strict eviction policy. Not because of government, so you don't go pay. Do you understand? So they build and they pay rent. The target where they come, you're able to fund road building for the next 25, 30, 40 years. So that's one thing I would change as well. Look at how many people are unemployed? How many people not get out? Because when man can't register to you, you say, I am unemployed. Yeah? Part of the profiling, you ask outside your day because you want your address. If you don't get address, then you don't say you're homeless too. So now we talk about national development, we connect the two things you talk about, people. When that person can we profile them, you get so much information about her, not just in work capabilities.
Definitely.
You also know who say it up. You don't know what speaking it gets. You don't know if you're pregnant or you're not pregnant. All those kinds of things. And when you're able to track all your citizens, you as government, you stand a better chance of actually making money from these people in relation to taxes. They're not in that black economy anymore. You actually give people an incentive for declaring themselves to government. You understand? So it's a win-win. It's a win-win because if I know who you are, I know where you are, who say you tap, Are they able to tax you as well? Are they able to provide a job for you? Because when I provide a job for you, you're going to pay tax. You're going to pay NASIT. So with the help of national development, that means NASIT fund will increase. The income of the tax person, registrar right now, I believe it's a woman, it will increase. Tax revenue will increase. And then the government they use for do things. So everything else, if all that they increase, then everything else, logically, for increase. So this thing about having that data center and knowing who is in the country and who is not in the country, it gets so many benefits. It gets so many different benefits. So now you don't know beforehand, as a government, you're able to get updated figures every day. Now this number of people, not only unemployed, but you also get the number of people that were homeless, already in inadequate accommodation. You're able to plan everything much better. You're able to plan everything much better. So you want to do your road building, you do it based on that. So you say, okay, now I want to do agriculture. Okay, focus your accommodation building based on your agriculture farm where you want to build, where you say go employ 1,000 people. Create simple, basic accommodation for these people. Then you provide a job for them, then they're paying rent. As they're paying rent in their jobs, they're paying taxes. Some of these mining, farming companies and things like that, they need services, you know? So people not only the one they go to the farm, but the logistical services, people can create companies around that for move goods from one point to the other. All those kinds of opportunities now are created by the fact that you just get a system of, I know who is unemployed, I know their ages, I know their education, I know their work background, I know their lack of skills, I know their accommodation status, family status, all those kinds of things. You know, I know their passions, I know what they would like to develop, what they would like to see, all those kinds of things you would have. So from that perspective, I mean, it's for me, that's my one thing that I would like to change in Sierra Leone. And I just think it will connect itself somewhere, because when you connect the people to something, then you really connect to everything else, because everything else revolves around what? The people. So to Mr. Slumlord and the people that we believe they're supposed to do something for them, then two basically need to get some sort of mind shift. They need to meet themselves up in the middle somewhere, you know? They need to meet themselves up in the middle. Mr. Government, therefore, understands that man, that's where his livelihood is. Not just a place for sleep, did he? Now, a place where he don't use to get in spot where they cannot do in the morning. He put it in a market to the cell, he gets spot. Nobody knows, they take that spot today. And then people, they know that on their way to work or on their way to their own business, whatever they do on the way home, they know that they pass to so and so person, they go open and they buy bread, butter or tea, or they buy coffee, or they buy cigarettes, or whatever. They know that. So it's like that ecosystem. You really try to deal with these people now. You cannot look and just a face, a number. You know what I mean? That guy at the slum, it cannot be just a number. You know, when he they talk about the slum, you know, they talk about just in your house. They talk about the whole community and what he gets from it. So it's a tricky one, but both people need to get that mindset shift. And national development most times is also short term. So if you're thinking about it, what would you rather have? Would you rather have the roads first and you drive along and yes, okay, everything is nice and sweet, but where are you going? Where are the roads leading me to? Or would you rather have a system? Because when you do the road, unless you do toll, you're not really making direct income from it. But when you build the houses, you get direct income from it, where you can put into roads and other things, you know, and that income as well. Unlike road, when you don't sink up without the toll, like I say, once you don't sink up on the road, that's it. It aids the economy, I agree. Now more vehicles can move up and down. Vehicles, they broke down less, all that kind of stuff, and as long as the roads maintain. It might also lead to increased traffic as well, because more people now are willing for drive because the roads are better. You know, some people, they don't want to drive because they go bad. They're not getting money for the fixing car. But now that I can drive along on smooth roads, so more cars might come on the road. So even though you build bigger roads, bigger lanes, it may not necessarily, if you don't get the right traffic management policy, it may not necessarily just lead to positive development. But when you build houses and people are in those houses and they're paying rent on a monthly or weekly or whichever way you want to charge basis, that's income coming in. And if you build you houses them properly, I mean, they can generate income for you for God knows 100 years. 100 years. So I would change that too for this Mr. Slumlord. If we look at the last two governments and they're in power, God knows, about 12, 15 years or whatever between them, it's a lot of time. So So if we don't get a house building policy going back to, say, the start of President Kabah in on time to now, I think we don't deal with slum lords and slum dwellers, the issue a long time ago. And now you now don't get assets then really generate income, which could have been going into building the same roads that we're building now. So that's what I would do for Mr. Slumlord. I wouldn't necessarily take him out of Bay and rebuild there. I would try to create new communities, count the number of people within the one old Bay. You know, we already get an idea because they're building in the voting election. But count them properly, know where they live, get the, again, you know, if I go back to this system of people registering themselves.
Yeah, definitely.
If you don't get, not so much in a Bay, you know, go can't register as unemployed. But the one they already did, if you don't get that one in the, you don't get a good idea of the number of people they already did. So within that system, you can see that actually now able for count the number of people in that whole community. Eh? You can institute a separate project if you want to count the total number of people and the total number of households to be particular. You know? Because these interventions, for me, when you're talking about, say, trying to create a job or trying to create a business for people, that intervention is at household level. You know what I mean? So the first goal will be, let me try to get each household generating an income. Do you understand? When somebody can't say, oh, unemployed, you want for no years, so wait till they go on at the family, you're not able to sustain them for now, before they even be priority. Yes, so instead want for do something. But with everything, scarce resources, limited resources, you get for prioritize. So that way, they are homeless, you don't get nothing, you put them first. You try really hard to get them into something over that one way, in family, then a lawyer and stuff like that. They, you don't done university, they just not get job yet. But he's still self eligible for can register. You understand? So we know they say not to priority you. At the end of the day, that will not get nothing. You must get some priority, like maybe you can find housing and then kind of anything. So that's where I would stop in relation to waiting for the slumlord.
Quick question. I don't know if you get any idea because I have no idea. Do we have like job centers? Now, salon-like agencies, do we have any? You have any idea for that?
As a broad question we ask, I go say yes, because there are people who help people find jobs. So we have a lot of private agencies where there are people that forget jobs.
Yeah? Okay. Okay, now...
The government itself, though, a few years ago, I think about three budgets ago, they actually include a line in the budget we then call job centers. Yeah? So the government recognize this kind of system. But if my memory serves me right, the amount of money where you convert them, the amount of money we then put to this is like $100 and something $1,000.
Okay.
So when you try to scope the problem, the size of the problem, the number of people that are potentially unemployed in Sierra Leone, and then you think of $100 and something thousand, you know, it's not a lot of money. So at the time, we didn't get this, and I commend the government, President Nkrumah and government, for doing that. Because my view is, the fact that it don't be in the budget as a budget line item right now is a very good start. It is a recognition of the problem. I know certain people who don't see them, they don't talk about it for they actually make it that far. Do you understand? Because a lot of things get discussed, and then they don't make it into the budget. So for let a line appear that says job centers and then an amount, fantastic. Obviously, since we find Sierra Leone in a state of emergency, the normal constitution is suspended. I hope people are not forgetting that one day. So budgets obviously kind of reflect what we were fighting. Do you understand? What needs to happen now is the system need for be a national system. That's what needs to happen. So we not get a national system. We get centers where people can go and actually declare themselves. Some might say you can go to the ministry, but then what happens? What if you go and go register somewhere? What happens? What mechanism do we have? So for me, whichever way we deal with these people now, it is wholly inadequate in Sierra Leone. Wholly inadequate. The system needs to expand from a regional system to a national system that embraces and engages everybody. You know? Sierra Leone gave me a slogan, we all for better. Not so 1-2 months for better, we all for better. We all for better.
That's not true. Like, we all for better.
We all for better. And so for any party, if that means slogan, people in, I don't really listen to you today. Yeah, all for better. No, you know, party day, talk about our name. We all for better.
Yeah, definitely. All. Talking about we all for better, draw me next sideway, me one focus on change.
Uh-huh.
When you look at the way things are happening in Sierra Leone, I make example for the first one, the Okada them. When David Cisse be there na radio, wait he talk, say happen. When he go the meeting, they never dialogued. They don't get exactly what they want them for do. Then give and paper say sign naya. Now this we want una for do. When he come to Kube, the man say, they no ask them, they no tell them anything, they just tell them, say, this is what is going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
Me, wait till I want to see change, now forget everybody involved. So until we get for affect me, you have to involve me in decision making so that I go understand who side you dey come out from.
Mm-hmm.
Because if I don't understand who you dey come out from, now they bring who me go rebel against you. Maybe you have a genuine, you get proper meaning, thinking to say, this is going to save this situation. This is the best way out of this particular situation. But because you come as a dictator to me, like you're going to tell me what to do, like I have no power, now the rebellion, they come inside. So in this aspect, me feel say everything that affects any and everybody should be involved in that particular decision making. I don't know what you think about this, Bolo.
Well, it's. I totally agree with Anne. I make Alejo use the word engage. When you allow two-way dialogue, then you don't engage people. Do you understand? You get for engage people. You get for understand which people they want, which are their own views, which are their own motivations, which are their own perspectives on whatever you bring, saying that for their own benefit. That is critical to success. So I go totally agree with that you suggestion day for change. Because if we not do that one day, then we will continue for see the kind of results we're having now. And me and you know say, you can't continue for do the same thing and expect for see a different outcome. Life just does not work like that. Development just does not work like that. You can't grow if you are in a position where you need for grow, but you continue for do the same thing to put you in the position where you need to grow. Your behavior must change. Your thinking must change. So this is what we need in Sierra Leone. This is what we need in Sierra Leone. A lot of these initiatives, they come, but we get to ask yourself why Sierra Leone is not embrace all of them. Why will not embrace all of them? Some of them come, but somehow we not embrace all of them. And it gets a lot to do with a lot of things. And some of it gets to do with the fact that if somebody not getting daily bread, now that's it, they focus on force. You know, they focus for other things, developing community. These are, it's just not for know how they eat. Our the pay transport for go work, the feed me picking them, the buy school uniform, the pay school fee. Now they tell you no more than I need for now until you're able to do anything and make comfortable one. Now they begin remember and say, okay, well, how would they develop the church? Like begin, you know, all the funny thing in it. So it is about you get to engage people then where you want for make the life better. Because at the end of the day, now then your life you want to make better. The only time we know they engage people, now we do something for let BC and say you do something. We're not about you. You understand? Because you already know what you are achieving, which you are achieving now. For them and say, oh nah, Mr. B been do this thing. Then it becomes about you. So the only person you will need for engage then now yourself. But if you really want to make change in people in lives, come on, you must ask them, this thing I want to do for you. I want to be sure. You know? It will really help you, eh? Because think about it. We're all not in a position where somebody can ask you for support. Maybe if you put her in this day abroad, say, in context, sometimes you fumble in a salon, they don't call you, say, I want to go to school, or I want to go to this vocational institute, or I want to study this. you know, just be send the money go get more. Well, at least me, I don't know for that possible. Me, I not go just send the money go get because you say, oh, you want to education.
Exactly.
Well, ask him a good question. That's also.
Definitely.
Which you want to study? You know, we don't. We whose job if you see you get? I'm not saying he pays so for the job then the. Then job then the more cool. You know, I go ask you 2-3 questions. Not so for bad, but I go ask you 2-3 questions and I don't see the money what they give you, so they go pan good. So, now because all that everyone wangi now, not about you. But, if it is about me in that situation, the way you call me, you ask me, ah, are they put you on speaker for us, we the talk. Let all my ear first, we the ask me. You understand?
Yeah.
And they put you on speaker. Then, when I send the money, go give you, and then they ask you too much stuff. As I send the money, go give you, ah, at the beginning, take picture for us, why are they Western Union? Why are they at the counter? Are they only money so? You know, I take selfie with the counter man. I will take selfie where they don't make you where they don't put the thing for sending money to with your name. I take picture. I go post on a Facebook, WhatsApp, I send them, you know, I say, yeah, I sent $100 or $500 to my cousin or friend in Sierra Leone today to help them with education. That's what I would do. Because in that scenario, it's about me. I don't go ask you no question. But when I want help you or want to make sure this is what they do, they help you for go before. I go ask you them question in there about how this thing make you go before. You understand? I go ask you, say, hey, that the last one is that they do for you, and you can know while you could begin calling me next month back, see, you want that one. You go reassure me. You tell me, say, yeah, don't worry. This service I don't want, so are the serious, are the this, are the that. And the other thing is now, I go interested for like the same me results. Are you the pass? Are you the do? You know? Who say, well, you say your exam, oh, I get exam, then they give you exam at the end of the first term. I go say, okay, well, send me the results, because while I send you more, send me that result the first bar. That's what you would do. Now, lie, they lie?
No, definitely. Definitely.
And that's my view. That's what you would do.
Yeah, definitely.
It's about the other person. You naturally, trust me, you naturally, they get interest for ask all these questions, for engage in the dialogue we usually talk about. So, I don't just go, mix it on, I get 1 million, then I just watch them from a crew, but I say, you know what, we start to know themselves, and they go build one place for them, Sussex or Kent or whatever, I don't think we'll like her. Come on, I don't know them, I don't know how many are there, I don't know what they value. Some man value city life. Some man he want for dinner in village, life, quiet, no noise, all them things in there. So, you know, so that's what it is. If you really want to develop people, then I just think it is a natural instinct. And these are the mindset changes we as Sierra Leoneans, we get for me. That's the ultimate change. The ultimate change is we're dealing with the masses is people recognizing that we of itself, we will change we mindset. So, again, I could say I've been so happy when Sierra Leone introduced the attitude and behavioral change secretariat and that whole program. Unfortunately, not deliver, waiting for deliver, because the attitude of the people that they run them when it just begin was not the right one. So, it kind of tarnished the image of it. But the concept of changing the mindset, the way they think, the way they process everything is very, 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 very important.
Yeah, I think
as well
we get text them we relate to that. And let's just go with the first text. This is Natamba Mose. He say, if I had the chance to change one thing in Sierra Leone, it will be undoubtedly the very one thing that hold us back from prosperity, which is to abide by the rule of law. He said, the why factor? We cannot achieve anything substantial without respect or fulfillment of full order of the rule of law. You see, and when they talk about the rule of law, they talk about everybody, be it leaders and be it the average Sierra Leonean.
Yep.
Yes.
We need to give a round of applause, don't
we? Yeah, definitely.
We need to give somebody a round of applause.
Yeah,
because
definitely.
That's it. Mindsets change. But then the problem with that, you see, the problem with that is, it's nice to say that, but then how, why is important? Boom. But we know now the challenge in actually getting people to change their behavior, it touches on so many other things. It touches on the person's expectation. For example, which they go get to go to court. So you get to deal with the masses on that front. You get to wonder, why are the legal people, the lawyers, the judges, why are they doing funny things? You get to wonder, you understand what I'm saying? So you get to wonder, all man get you agenda.
Yes.
as to why not stick to the rule of law. And then if you now as a normal citizen, you see the one that really, you say, okay, they are not the day before, they not the follow the rule of law as Tamba say. You see the leaders not the follow the rule of law, then you say for just be inclined for what? Do the same. Because that's the environment that the leadership they prescribe and encourage. You know what I mean? So good one though, Tamba. Good one.
Yeah, we get another one for Kemon Mansare. You see, I think I think if I have the opportunity, and so are all Sierra Leoneans, you say one thing we ain't gonna change. One thing is integrity from within. If we all change our greed mentality and understand how our actions affect others, it will be a huge step in moving forward.
Yeah, I like that name. The reason I like that name is I devised a program a few years ago. Now that can impact they even forget. Me believe see an organization like SLBC, Serum Broadcasting Corporation, the TV side in particular, they get an opportunity for create a series of programs, whether you want to call it just an infomercial, whether you want to call it whatever you want to call it. But a short program, we basically, they deal with an aspect of corruption, go through the act of itself, and then extrapolate now and show the potential outcome of it, right? The full impact of it. So let me give you an example of what a short program would be like, because we need to do this, because some people are not able to understand the wider impact of their actions. All they see, like I say, is the bread that they need to buy when they leave work. So this has actually happened to somebody who I know. One time in the way they say you need to go take a national ID card for do XYZ. The office in the Dong One Road near Cotton Tree, right? So when you go to this office, if you not get certain stuff for show, now they do more, they don't allow you for go inside. So now they get people, then they we can come for whatever reason. Then they stop them. So, you for show me this ID and da 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 da. So someone can say, well, but I had the camp can't take the ID. So yeah, it kind of doesn't make sense for me not to get in. Yeah. But so what is somebody do now? Is you go make three things on that thing, which was maybe an oversight in the rule somewhat. I can understand why they run for security and all that, and associate to go apply for. So when you get to the point, I guess, where you need for do this form, maybe I would think logically you get for sure, say, I am who I am. But you could go into the building if you say, well, I don't get ID and I really need to get this national ID thing. I need to register. So therefore, really, I have you for go in. Now, what these people are doing is they'll take small things, right? Even if you're not sure the right thing, they'll take small things and then they allow you for go inside. So imagine somebody now will refuse. You say, I know they pay this thing. The person we happen to, he been to go for a job. The job, they say they want a national ID card because the job is for national service unions.
Okay.
So they want for seeing national ID card, which was a good thing. So the you stopping that person for that 2,000 euros or something, even for taking a hand for like going inside, or 5 grand away, if for give you bribe before they go inside. You stopping them for 2,000 euros means he end up, because he get for one going to try for going to also go take driving license or this or that or something for come because you know I'm paying that money. Danny now stop him from getting the job because then he will process the ID card on time. Now this job not a UN job, we really pay quite a high salary, benefits and all that kind of thing, education for in children and all that kind of stuff there. So if we begin to now quantify some of the things that the way the individual they lost just from that one day. You now think of you and the people in picking education later on. Almost standing a course in America and they study and stuff like that. You think of the benefits, the pensions and all that kind of stuff. Now, if you see them and done properly, you're able to show that person they say in 2,000 euros, we stop that person from going into that place, getting an ID card, initially knock-on effect. It run into hundreds of millions. Hundreds of millions. Because they say, why is that person they work? If you for them below, we go to rent. All the kind of thing you're able for depict and to people let somebody imagine your typical Sierra Leonean average civilian sitting at home watching TV. I think it's about highly educated, of course, you know. Just your typical normal civilian sitting at home watching TV, and then he sees himself in that. He sees, wow, now that job there, they do kind of thing. And then he see the impact to it it caused. If that person is not a religious person, maybe just on that ground, you go think, wow, think twice about what you need for do. Do you get what I'm saying? We need for do these kinds of things. Let people in the Sidom, and they watch anything there. So when we there abroad, we watch some of these what we call soap operas. If you watch like England, EastEnders, Coronation Street, then they depict life as it is in the UK. Then they deal with the norms, the issues that are going on, all that kind of stuff. Then. So we may not have the resources to do a proper soap like that. But we can do these little programs. I push this thing to like ABC Secretariat. I say, this is something you can do. Because when I mean just change on leadership, Ajibola Thomas or whatever his name is, they call the people in. They're like, here, come, share ideas with us of things to do. I was one of those people. I've been working at TNA with a partner, Etta. We're an actress now. She had a lot of ideas as well in relation to what can be done to change the mindset of the typical Ceridian. But that's one of the kind of things I would love to see ABC Secretariat and like SLBC collaborate and do. They pick these things. When you go into a bank, you stop somebody from going into the bank and able to take money that they need for go buy electricity or for buy eat for picking or whatever. You see all these little things. Just depict these kinds of things. It would show where the teeth from your employer, the impact that you have. We you know, they do things properly in relation to mixing things properly, you know. From behind the bar, all kinds of different scenarios we can just depict. People need to see these things and actually see the effect in the full impact over time. Do you understand? Over time, let someone see and let begin quantify in your mind, say, everybody senior, so I say they get out, and I say, yeah, the biggie, okay, all those kinds of things. Deal with the people, deal with their mindset. If we want for change the mindset of Sierra Leonean, that's the kind of thing that I would do. If I would do one thing, that's what I'll do. I go stop for the talk to Sierra Leonean and say, you need for do. You need for change this. You know, say corruption not good. When you do that, I would stop that shouting at them and telling them what to do in that sense. I would really stop doing that. I would rather just basically try for getting to their mind slowly, subconsciously, and just making them actually see also the full impact of their actions.
Okay, we get another person we send text. We go na Ibrahim K. It's if they na the aspect of the rule of law. He said, I believe any nation that has respect for the rule of law is likely to be successful in economic, social, and political affairs. Nonetheless, that's not the job of one person, because it should be the utmost responsibility of every Sierra Leonean that is concerned. That's not from Ibrahim K.
It's very true. It's generic, but it's true. It's true in the sense that now we all get for doing. One person not able to just say, you know, well, I'm going to change the religion. The only person really, ultimately, in all of this, you know, when we begin this conversation, I say this should not be about, oh, if I change the minister or whatever. No, it's not that level. Unfortunately, the one person that I know that can make a huge difference to all of these things in given how Sierra Leone works is the president. In our big, I would say the only person, you know, we don't establish, say, I guess, supreme executive powers and all of that. He can, you know, he can do things. So he is basically the only person that I would say, and in a daily way, we go for empower people for do certain things. So apart from him, there's no other single individual we would say in your way, because if you didn't have a certain position, you have to do certain things. Let's be real about Sierra Leone. Who doesn't like it? You don't like it. But if you're in a certain position and you want to do things that the power of the day don't like, then they will just get rid of you. It's a simple fact of life. Let's not beat about the bush on that one. So ultimately, for let certain things happen, it has to come from the very, very, very top in a country like Sierra Leone. It has to come from the very, very top.
Okay, we get Dulman Conte. He say, for build government medical facilities in each community and affordable for the citizen. Free medical treatment for those that qualifies for it. In that day, I go put an asterisk, because how can you determine who is qualified for it? We go kind of side it. He say, I will have a program that... Okay, no, let me just stay to one side. So let we come to the, because the name allowed, but one will be in say. Let we just, Dulman Conte, he say, build government medical facilities in each community and affordable for the citizens. He say also free medical treatment for those that qualifies for it. But how can we determine who is qualified for it? So we come back again to what we talked earlier about database. And I don't know what you get for say towards this.
Well, you know, I like the first issue, is how do you know who qualifies for it? So when you say you're changing it, what exactly are you going to change? It's okay. It's like saying it's going to change the medical system and create medical facilities. How are you going to do it? How are you, you need to, I mean, it's about, if you are government, then obviously you have the funds to do it. You get for now think, okay, how do I sustain the free medical side of it? You know, because everything here would be sustainable. For you get development, like I say, it takes time. So how do I fund it? How do I sustain it? Many things that you can do, obviously. There are many different ideas, many ways that you can fund things. But then that is not necessarily the inside this conversation. You then go just sidetrack with. But the key thing, normal way, Dulman get for just consider is, okay, yes, I am government, priorities, that is something that definitely needs to be done. I totally agree with him. What I would say is, if I'm doing something like that, I would try for create specialist units in each one of those facilities. So if you're going to start with four regional hospitals, north, south, east, and west, then try for make sure, say, one day look at specializing, not necessarily just treat that, but you get a specific research center, let's say maybe for cancer, or maybe another one for some of our tropical diseases. Do you understand? Maybe you get something else for some disease where they affect children, you know? Maybe you get a fourth one where they focus on development, research and development into traditional medicine. Because if you want to do free medical, the easiest way for Sierra Leone to afford free medical is if Sierra Leone produce medicine way effective. And the fastest way for Sierra Leone to produce medicine way effective now by looking at real herbs and spices and see what we can formulate for help for keep the population healthy, you know? So, again, it is about each one way you look at, you get one look at how do I make it lead to national development. And I think this program, if you get forget to follow on, it has to be the third question, which is the how. Because today we're looking at, we think you will change. If you get one chance to change one thing like Sierra Leone, which thing you go change and why? The final part is how. I think we need to dedicate a whole program to that. They just think talking about how do we actually now put these medical centers in place. Let's begin to try for, in a way, you know, so, say you can get people that really listen to your program and they might be in position for effect some of the changes we already discussed. So from that perspective, it would nice for you to look at it.
Famulen, sorry, I think we lost Ambolo, but just stay right there as we go come right back. Just stay right there. Yes, Famulen, we sorry we be lost Bolo, but we are back on live and we get we daily contributor we can always then at this show. When Yusuf Ba from Atlanta, I think he don't follow the program. And Bolo, are you there, sir?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay, just making sure you're there. Yes, Yusuf, what do you think about this topic we will talk about today?
The basis for this, you know, one thing I may say, I just want to say thanks to the listener that we listen currently and we don't listen in the past. They know the fundamentals we all can talk about are the basic one, fundamental human rights for everybody in the country. We start with education because the value of education can be respected not just by the individual with the good school, but in parents them as well. For make the lasting impact school be experienced, it's supposed to be. And in turn, we all know within education, no matter how small, whether in a formal education in a classroom or whether in the other education when I practical on way you get for attain them through apprenticeship. You know, all the one in the individual and the people them around the individual them value whatever the form of education is, it could be more beneficial to the individual and the community we belong, and how that could be experienced. We all day we say we day respectively, Europe and the US and elsewhere. We all know within education. Education, you know, to within people in the talk say, you know, now would I go classroom. Standard of education at the West is not a right, and in the foursome. Now, either you put your picking go school or you homeschool them. But either way, you get for their power with the educational standards of that community they with them belong. So me, I did tell you the way forward and waiting I will change that salon and why. Now this is not the educational standard. We get for make sure say people in value them. If you want to change somebody's attitude, one English person say you can fatten a pig on its market today, you know, go wait to see the person already for Canada job market. You can say they can forget these credentials, forget the work. We all know how people they get mostly. I'll rephrase that sentence. Say, we all know the standards of civil service in Salon when are the higher employer as opposed to the private sector. So we all know waiting at the standards in there. Most people that graduate from the respective or different universities and colleges in Salon, but at the end of the day, they don't even get an opportunity to get employed by one of the parastatals or the government entities. After that, the one day we opportunity to get somebody, we get connection there, as we all know, quote unquote, that the way that the people in the Duam. This is an abuse. And we can make it that need to take hold now because the people then generally, the general mass, not get the basic education. Because if everybody get the basic education, they get the discipline, we come along with that. And we can have some of them discipline in there. You get for respect rule of law. You don't say, I the Canada's working because I get sababu for Canada work. That because I don't go to school or I don't go to training for get this work. So with respect to that, they respect the job and you'll get for executing responsibilities them more responsibly. With that, the person within a supervisory role will look and say, this person, he didn't have this work not because he get connection, not because of merit. Either I get the education or he get the training for the job. And on and on and on and on. We all know if we get for make that country they get a foothold in a stronger future, the investments get for be solely and primarily on the educational aspect of that country there. Yes, not until we will observe the changes then within the shortest possible time, but it will influence generations where they come, we go impact the changes and they will put Salon at the track they would expect them to be. Years like this, 2016, not until as I follow up now the program just lately before the line cut off with Bolo, we all see waiting to happen. I mean, we all know standards. If you're ready for a good interview for a job, first and foremost, you get your identification, you get your ducks in a row, your certificates, we get for proof, say, qualify for the job, or you get a curriculum vitae of your resume for, you know, highlight your experience or your education. How somebody will graphically forget stuff like that, they're not prepared. So all landing are because of the readiness not being day, or I don't want to give the individual the benefit of the doubt, but if you know that you have a goal, you don't prepare. And also one, they not just call you less than an hour or two or say you can't interview. They don't tell you way in advance, at least a week or 2 weeks until you say cancel today. You put only ready 1 week before that day, 5 days before that day, 2 days, 1 day, couple of hours before the interview for go meet with the person. So all of this now we readiness careful, go back to the beginning and the basis now, basic fundamental education and the respect for rule of law. This goes now the widespread now with community, civil servants, government officials, police. If policeman come to me, he no in your right. If it execute in irresponsibility, he no say myself, that the citizen, he no me own right. Then they go add to me no me own right, plus the policeman no me own right, and he no your own rights and responsibilities. Lo and behold, we no go get things to argue about, because if I don't create an infraction with the law, I know where tonight. Well, so if somebody asks me, I start pleading right there for mercy, or if I want to be arrogant, I'll be arrogant and they arrest me. But if the policeman come, you know, it's an infraction, if he quotes the infraction, we occur, he arrest me on that basis. But you know, just come on blanket, he tell me I don't do things where I don't do, or he try for to put wool on me, yeah. So in essence, I mean, we get for go back to the basis. Now. We get for go to the basis. The basis now, education. This is now one thing where if I would change today, I will influence that part there gravely for influence the future of Salon.
Okay. Thank you, Yusuf. But before you go, Bolo, I don't know if you get for add or subtracting anything where Yusuf say.
Well, it's generic. So we say all Mango agree with in relation to education, changing education. When we talk about education is so broad. There's formal education, there's the informal education. So again, now we can see you get for talk about the how. We're not getting time today, but we probably get for where you go into the how. You know what I mean? For say I want to change education and get everybody educated, nobody's going to say no to that. It is about what do you mean by education. Do you mean formal education? I go to school, I go study this, and I get this bachelor's degree? Or does education include how I teach you, like I say, to put on your seatbelts when you're driving, because it's going to save lives? Do you know what I mean? So that one makes sense. In relation to the example of Abinigi, the preparedness, it only applied to this fellow, because what happened here was when somebody don't go for in job, he don't actually get the job, he don't get interview, it wasn't an interview, he don't go for the job. When he get the job, that's the only point where the first way to give you the job will tell you, so and so I want. Do you understand? So at that time, there was a valid reason why they may insist on this, like I say, the getting your national ID card. There were lots of reasons why it was being pushed and why the system as it was. So it was just one of those things that coincided where employers were never asking for it, and today I'm sure a lot of employers don't even ask for it. But that period in Sierra Leone's time, which was a unique period, people were asking for it. They were pushing the national registration of every citizen to go get a national ID card. Because why? One of the reasons was people anyway, the old Sierra Leonean passports, they're not really Sierra Leonean because the passport was kind of easy to get. So as an employer now, I want to say, because I don't see the rigors with them put, for actually you get the ID card, the biometric aspect, all that kind of stuff in there. So it just coincided. Do you understand? So now he now prompts this issue of people now stopping people at the gate being difficult because they know, say, there's an emergency, there's a push to get this card. You know, say, that push now indicates the demand for stopping people from going into offices and starting to take money. So it all goes back to waiting Yusuf and everybody else to talk, because when you follow the rule of law, the discipline and everything else, when I come in that place, not so you to do the verification. Your job is really to just verify that I'm Sierra Leonean. Because when we go there, the guy say, he look at me first, he say, I may not look Sierra Leonean. I can understand that. But when I talk to her, he say, okay, you sound Sierra Leonean. And he let me in. That's his job. His job is not to verify me, is not to process me in any way. It's to have a good idea that I'm Sierra Leonean. So in essence, if somebody can't even sound Nigerian, he gets reason for doubt. And not necessarily means he's not to Sierra Leonean, because he might be Sierra Leonean, we don't grow up in Nigeria. So you get what I'm saying? So it is, it's a unique situation in that one, and I really feel that kind of person there, you have a huge impact, because when you now look at that particular scenario, you go to something, they say, okay, go get this card and bring it. If that person allows you to go inside, it means your stuff gets processed faster. If any kind of delay happen, whether that person may be aware of that delay they get for happening or not, maybe cards run out, there's so many things, and remember what I'm saying, we're not depicting a real scenario, we try to use a scenario for educate people. It goes back to Yusuf's point. It's about education. That's just another form of education. So I totally agree with Yusuf on the need to educate Sierra Leonean.
All right. Thank you very much, Bolo. And thank you, Yusuf. Yes, I want to carry with this now, Esther Shillon. He said, I would like to change the cleaning and sanitary situation in Sierra Leone. I would like to provide cleaning equipment and encourage the people of Sierra Leone to keep our motherland clean. I miss the 80s in Sierra Leone. It was very clean. Yes, Bolo, what do you say about the cleaning aspect?
Well, Esther, waiting for saying that we grew up in the 70s, Yeah, but I mean, it's you know, cleanliness is next to godliness. Not my words, it's in the Bible, apparently. So, you know, it is we need for be clean, and again, education. I need for know why I need for be clean. If I don't understand the impact of me being clean, or the diseases I can catch and the diseases I can pass on to people, then I'm not gonna be clean. It's one of those things. And we know say for keep clean, it actually you can keep clean without spending any money, but it costs a bit of money as well, because you ideally gonna make for you some soap and all these kind of things. So when people are poor, if it's between eating and buying soap, then we know somebody's gonna eat. So a lot of things need to come. But then again, it's about how many people are packed up in a particular area and the amount of waste we then just naturally they generate. What kind of logistical systems do we need to actually follow up before clear that they up? So we don't know how many people actually this on site where they generate dirty. So how will they deal with that? How will they address that? Will they see the challenges where like the company where they clear dirty in a second when they get right now? Because then they be overwhelmed. They'd be overwhelmed. So, Esther, we need you. We need Dulman in Sierra Leone on the medical side. We need Yusuf in Sierra Leone for dealing with education. So, we just need people to do things. We just need people them for do things. And as you say, somebody talk about now this I want to really me talk to. I'm just asking them which they would like for change. They say they go left for see an independent being able for run for member of parliament and president and all that kind of stuff they need. Because part of the problem we then see is the system of political parties. Do you understand? So yeah. Maybe that's what we kind of need. We need Yusuf to be running for getting himself in a position where he can be maybe impact on education. Maybe we need Esther on with cleaning. We need Dolman medical. Okay, more they talk about integrity, so we need an ABC. Somebody talk about abide by the rule of law, so maybe we need him in somewhere in the judiciary. It get for be about like minds coming together with the agenda for real prosperity ultimately.
Okay, we get another one from Paul Mark. Paul Mark in Bisna Tamale Ghana, one of the people that we can always take part by the show. He said, one of the things I feel could strengthen our development is to work on the revenue collection system. He said, a lot of cash is being paid on the counter, and this leads to corruption.
Mm-hmm. It's true. It is true. The more money they pass on, me to you, the more for corruption. When the first time in England, when you get on the bus, you pay on the bus, right? And you tell the driver how many stops you're going to go, and then you pay based on those number of stops. Lots of people get on the bus and will say, okay, they go 2 stops instead of 6 stops, and then you pay less. And then you sit on the bus and you hope a conductor not can't ask for your ticket. So once you do that money business day, problem they come out. The people already run the transfer system now, so they realize, say, with a lost book of money. People then they can and they rob the drivers at gunpoint, all that kind of stuff, and they happen. So now, for example, you get a system where you get a card. You just take that card, the way you get it for travel on bus. And on a bus, you go inside, you get it, how you put them, they really pull the money, it will charge you for go inside, they go. If you're going to you take train, it's the same thing, you put the money. So that day, what they do, it help the company, them, with the redundant transport system there, so, for collect the money, because it's all electronic. If we get the wheel, the systems and they right now, as I said, for a lot of things happen, through the mobile phone, for example. Now, one simple way, we get one of the mobile companies in Sierra Leone, they do...
Airtel Money, something like that.
Airtel Money, they own money business. Let me get another one at one point. I don't know who's in there right now. Splash Money has been there. So the system there, we go able to replicate this electronic money. Now, we own electronic money, and we will not get debit card and credit card and too much in a second. It did, but not too much. But all man, you know, every house will get mobile phones. So he will do a lot more on we mobile phones than they go app. But now, whether the company that we they do their mobile phone business, they also, whether they're ready for do all and kind of thing, or whether private investor go feel like the rule of law, go support them for like come in and invest and run them kind of business, and they everything is connected. But revenue connection, there's, even though they use the phone system, other way than they will also now bring people in, because technology get this bad habit for minimize jobs. It can take away jobs from human beings. And a country like Sierra Leone, we will get high unemployment. It's not necessarily not always the right answer for just bringing the latest technology with it really just kill jobs. Let me take like electricity. You know, electricity is alone now the longer this charging system. That system being a system where really you, why you for need for going to electricity house like continue tree for go charge your key. That is something you will do in any shop, anywhere, any hour, petrol station, full of man shop, even with those dorm, everywhere. Because electricity lost money. So man the way he want for top up the electricity at a certain time, but he just not physically able to go there. So the electricity lost money. So government they lost money. So man the way want for dorm, but the place not lock. So the hour we want to do at 9 o'clock, the place not lock. 10 o'clock in the night, the place not lock. So enable dorm. So electricity they lost money. That period they lost money. And many of you say we electricity company they in the position where they lost money. When we can come in now for pay bills tomorrow, and obviously they're in a position for impacting cash flow in that way. So it's national development, you need different you need different thinking, different way for process, what we want for do. We need to understand the impact of the thing that we want for do, you know, what you mean, yeah, what you mean yanda, how we will reach here, how we will reach yanda. It's so important that we as a people first, we understand which in the national development and the challenge we have presents to we, and then we also understand the benefits we will get just if we just develop a country, if we just develop we safe as individual. I get this program that they push right now is just each one teach one. You know, think of that, you sabi do something, you teach this one. At this point, we listen to schools here, we will try for get teachers, pupils, janitors, everybody involved in a group type exchange, where each person is able to teach just one person in the group something that they don't know already. You know, this is how we as an individual get to think about national development, which we will able do. You understand? Which we able do one by one by one by one by one. In poor schools, they say when you have people picking and not get eat. We need to introduce a spin-off of each one teach one, which is each one feed one. All these kinds of little things, we get to think, how would it able impact in real small ways, how would it able impact even at this time, and what kind of change it will bring. If you will make one Pekingo school and eat, like how Yusuf they talk, it's not a better chance to get educated. Because Peking within a classroom in LA empty, you're not able to learn, just being there not enough. Just being there is not enough.
Where will they talk about this particular Saibolo, the money mm-hmm. transaction, yeah? Mm-hmm. I know say one particular area in a salon where they say go pay in a bank right now in Awataki. But mm-hmm. now the integrity and attitude change all come in. Because at the end of the day, mm-hmm. outside the bribe they come, where you don't go pay in the bank, where you come back in the key, you get for hand over your paper. And when you hand over the paper, they get a section back where you get for now your own physical money you get for GI for make them push your paper. Now so then call them for push the paper go before. Because if you not push the paper go before, just say because I don't go pay in a bank, that's the end of it. Me when I not get money transaction, your paper go sit down there forever. We now they want bring Yusuf inside. Waiting, okay. Yes. Now, we they talk about this side for the money transaction and everything, and Bolo don't elaborate small. Now I want me don't care with Usai. Yes, you go pay in a bank. That's what they're doing. You pay in a bank. You all wait yourself. But when you come back, for let the paper go before so that you go come out there in time. Now the bribe you get for coming inside. So what do you say in that area there?
You know, na very tough area. I mean, you hit time not here. Na integrity. You know, the basic thing here is, I don't see why me, you, Bolo, we go come on here. We travel from we homes, so we respectively go now another different city. In fact, low make them a different state within you country where they out in we don't case the US. I can come on Georgia and go as far as Montana. I will need something in Atlanta. I will call just a simple phone call. I'll make that phone call there and call somebody and say, hey, look, I need this paper pronto. What do you need? You want to make a fax them or want to email them? They'll give me the options and they'll send them to me. No questions asked. All they need to just do verify, say, I mean, at the legitimate person way, entitled to that information. The reason I bring this, I could just show how the ease of doing business is in the West, then because of the integrity in the systems to start with, not to just the individual. That the integrity in the system. Now, the we don't get fractured systems. We don't get fractured policies in Salon for a long time. And, you know, credibility come, integrity come, morals come into play. After we don't go, you don't go pay, you had an taxed bargain or your end of the bargain. Or say you get your container or you get your piece of luggage where you get for clear through customs or through the Wataki or through the port. You don't come and tell you you get for pay 15,000 leones. You don't go and say, look at the account, you should go pay them, then give you a receipt for cash show, say you don't get them. It's just as easy as that point if things been at the normal stands. For me, you will come. Knock, knock, on a meeting next. Okay, I don't come. This time, paper, I don't pay. It's easy for me to come, then stamp your paper, and good, you're good to go. But we all know this not happen. This could be very critical for making it happen at Salum. The simple fact is, I factoring a couple of issues. When the salary scale, is it a par with the person in standard of living? Then a one. Two, waiting at the time frame within the pay this person, this adequate or inadequate salary. Now imagine this. You don't pay somebody the X amount of leones you pay them for month. Within that month, the expenses then higher than waiting it they make based on his salary. It's usually the temptation long time, right? If you see, say, it they make less, I get for Fenway ID cost for make more for meeting in standard of living. And the other thing is, if it take 30 days for getting salary, let me just say we get paid on a 30-day salary days business. How tough it is for this person to survive on his salary and wait for another 30 days for making get paid. We all know this, that this person, if you don't spend his salary, he trusts as much or close to half of his salary, where he don't get indebted, but make it go make up for go pay. As soon as he gets his salary, he go don't spend that all done. So this is a part of things the way we see it create the corruption of them, and that very, very, very wataki. Case in point, simple things. You know, I'll come to this again, but I go on for go back to a couple of things where if you go permit me, please. Esther mentioned about the cleaning. I hate to go back, but I want to do this. You know, we all, like Bolo said, cleanliness are next to godliness. If at all people know waiting dinner with garbage, for some other reasons, we will find better way for dispose of them. Most of this na recyclable stuff them. Most of them think they would trash that things they would reuse. If the people then get the knowledge of how we do that, it could be very easy. People don't build houses and greenhouses then on an experimental basis with water bottle, the empty container. All we can then do for create a greenhouse, for create a house where they conserve proper energy, then take them water bottle in there, put sunshine inside, and stack them, and create an abode with a shelter, you know, family of 3, 4, 5. Then build them properly with that in there. It provide a conducive living for the people. This has been there online, and sure, I'm TED Talks. Now, if we all know, for the one that we're too familiar to go by Western, will be the pass for go Bome, for go St. Edward. You know how that place even smell? We all know even know. At one point, we realized, say, people can plant some machinery there. We don't even know to say the gas where they come up from that trash there, from that garbage there, when I maintain, then they turn them as a form of energy for electrify the house, for, you know, propel engines like motor car and all that kind of thing in there. Back in the 80s or early 90s, we see people in travel go do that in a bombing. But just imagine, the other garbage dump we've been there, like the new road by Dahatsu, we go by Kisianda. You know, all these places people don't know. We they look garbage, look now, simple stuff like water bottle, if they can't win a certain store them or certain state, they store in a bam 5-10 cents again from you. Bottle. You saw that bottle or you saw that can and they recycle them. You know, we not even know the impact of the create. Forget the degradation part of them we would contribute for just flood we waterways, we gutter them and end up for kill marine resources. No, we just look that impact. You can get that candy you put up. Some people they will go, if not to well that man say they go. You will cut some candy if the education they for make people and become handy. This will create job opportunities for individuals. Not only that, it will create a financial resource for somebody. Now, forget, if you don't look all that fast, say, would they improve with health just by that? Because the air clean, would they breathe safe? Then not only that, would they take care of we garbage properly? Would they dispose of the one we no need for day again? We recycle the one we need for recycle? And at the end of the day, some people make money out of them, but the incentive get for them, the institution get for them, is with the government get for them, you know what I mean? I mean, The other important factor here is the private sector. We all know places like Salon, private sector will only thrive if the private sector gets connected somehow. If they bring bids for even projects, we could bring them. Just imagine this. We don't know of people that will take projects going to Salon. We, they want to put them into practice. At the end of the day, they pack them bundle, come back, because the government make them very difficult for them to make them operate. Now, if the government told the drum, if people can come, we can give them incentives. So, you know what? Would they even, for you first year, would they provide you space there? No parent, do this. Do them. And that's when they, guess what? Like within Bolo say, each one teach one, the opportunity for people to get trained, the opportunity for make the person we can invest more, they get the encouragement for the. We all know. The incentive to go to other businesses like the mining companies where they need to be charging taxes. Taxes for mining companies where they yield millions, if not billions of dollars on an annual basis, then they get almost 0% interest or 0% interest, wherein you get the individual who will come when I last in effect, when they even cause harm to the land where we get. So think about it. You know, there's so many other ways. And the other one, we also want to piggyback on, we follow us how things can go change. You know, things can get for change not only from the government inside. We get for come back to, we said this not too long ago, decentralization. people then therefore come back to their constituencies. Now, they the governance they begin. The governance they begin from the people themselves. You know, because you get for rely, say, oh, me representative in a parliament, parliamentary, or my minister, I'm here, okay. You know what? At the end of the day, if you look for your communities in the West, if you look for community in the state of Georgia, like Texas, they're all mirrored. The different cities then get city councils, like how Freetown get city councils. Then council people that are there, homes them, inside them deal, the people they wouldn't represent. Then get for the listen to them, talk to them, like say, you know what, let me represent you, Naya. What do you want for me to do? Encourage the idea that the people they want, not to make it come from up to bottom, it get for come from bottom, go up. That way the influences will come, like for improve on the communism first, before they improve on the area. If this area don't develop to a point, you don't get good reason for me to come on at our school. They travel 5 miles for go to school, 1-2 hours away. But we all know places like the UK, schools in inner school districts within smaller communities, from primary school to secondary school, and then you probably think of branching out to bigger cities where they'll get the universities and colleges. But the primary aspect of governance is therefore start with the decentralization. Things therefore start at the small communities and from the people that they're able to get proper representation and get communities that will develop. And, you know, it only takes one for start this. If one community don't develop, then cut off, say, you know, we're picking the within at this area because of this reason or that. We don't want to make them travel come on, go 7 miles away for go school. We're able to find, we get qualified individuals in Salon in every aspect. From Jala to Private College to Christian College na Makini to all the other small communities that we're not build we that it stand for educate people in. We get people in. If you look, I just learned this very recently in last week. We not get over 4 or 5 people in way na qualified registered physical therapist na Salon. But you know what? The one that we register are only 5 or 4. If I quote this right now, pardon me if I make mistake. But me Lanche, I tell this individual, say, I know somebody when I think I'm member of parliament now, way na Atlanta come on, when I've been physical therapist. A common idea, it's a way to go Salon, it go ahead the diaspora office. That person, they've been there, they practice, or who knows? Why wouldn't they get professionals with the dudandi? But you know what? Some, they go, they not get the encouragement, or they not get the incentives to make them move in practice them fields. Instead, they branch out into something. But if we get them, this the influence will go happen is from the grassroots. If we start there, we say, this area na grass field. Nobody needs to come on here. They travel 7 miles to go to school na King Tom. If that same thing happened, they picking in the Komo all the way to see for Kang Grammar School, all the way picking in the Komo Eastern, way for Kang School na St. Edward's and Pio and all these other places. No, it don't need to be like that. If you're there around the Lomley, Juba area, you get services. You get the other small school, they make them develop in the one in there, so that they will influence and change the narratives. Get qualified teachers where they teach and give them incentives. Not let you go teach nothing to roads and this area idea. You know, go pay transportation too much for go far away. You begin and go dinner stock all day for canals with traffic and transportation. They'll come out of school, left, go also, go study, get time for study. If they get for help with house chores, then get time for doam. But just imagine, if me they come out east and they can't school na St. Edward's na King Tom, by the time they don't take transportation, go back na Kisi, na net at the age na house. Who's saying go the way I get for read me book and get the back for can't school na money? So, you know, a lot of things then, I come back to this monetization. The monetary aspect, I don't know if you remember this. Now remember we SLET been there with them begin institute and telephone booth and a Salon, na Freetown in particular. The card been there when that SLET card Where you go, now post office, you go buy them. You go buy them, then put your unit there. Where you come, you plug them inside the phone. Where you plug them at the public phone, as you go, when you talk, you
they show the timing, yeah, definitely.
We get.
Yeah.
You remember that?
Yes, yes.
You remember that, right? So guess what? If all of them things here, all of them systems, the systems in there, the only thing is, yeah, even though they are caged now, but the people of in the city, if somebody get for campaign electricity, they don't need for camp. We don't have an executive in the city of Ademba Road for campaign. They need to get the satellite places where you go, hey, I want to pay me electricity bill. Or I want load me electricity. If that the device you get, you can top your card, then you go put them inside the machine. As you need them to depreciate, they mark. Where you don't, they don't. Then cut your light. We all know that system they don't exist in London for the longest period of time. You know, then go do them. The standard then the only thing I would just enact them. And it's so funny, like you mentioned, somebody will go again, you go pay, like what may party tell me, say how would get for do this? Even if I don't go pay in a bank, I don't pay for my electricity at the bank. How long a get for take for make electricity land from the bank that I don't pay me bill? How long? The answer is immediate. But we not get the infrastructure for support that system there. And then the easy thing, Andy, if government get incentives for push them, believe you me, people in the West, we get the know-how. People in the West, we get the machinery. People in the West, we're able to come up with these functions. We then just need the basis for make then go and get the operation going. It's that simple. It's that simple. Credibility, honesty, and morals are the thing we back in terms of COVID corruption.
Okay. Thank you, Yusuf. Yes, I want to count Bolo. Bolo, you hear everything we Yusuf don't do in a nutshell. What are your thoughts?
Well, it's correct in all aspects. It's the kind of things that we need to do. It really is the kind of things that we need to do. It all starts from the top. Whichever way you look at it, it starts from the top. Because logistically, if I don't get enough for live on, like I say, then it's my priority. And they look now, how are they able to get enough for live on? So I'm willing to do certain things with the against the law for making that happen. And if so, the people then now we find themselves in this situation of not having enough for doing what they need to do, if so, whatever they find themselves, see, then are the one way actually supposed to be uphold the law, policeman, judge, you know, magistrate, then themselves will do the same thing, which is where we are. So I really don't want to focus on like where we are, what we're doing. It's more about we need for focus on what do we need for do now? Where do we go? How do we actually make this change? Because we understand the situation in so many different aspects. You know, politicians will come with and they promise you vote for me because me and you are the same tribe. Then I go do more for you. Well, we're not even supposed to encourage that kind of conversation there. We're not supposed to encourage with politicians them, and it's someone that we as the people, because ultimately the only way they can do anything for you now we give them the power invariably. Yeah, so tell us who will hire the person with the head tax office, but that really hire the one with the higher up. So now we, in the end, they do this thing by itself. But the problem with that is the lack of education. I mean, already they talk about formal education. It's more all of it, formal, informal, all of it. The lack of education is people don't understand that they really have the power, and then they can ask more questions before they actually give their vote. Some anyway, at the end of the day, you know, this is not how I grew up, and that's what I get for the now this nine this how they. The only thing I go say to that person, they can't person in now forget these holistic changes. You kidnap before another human being, you can say anything. No, so you can say yes, now you had to go vote, so you had to go vote. So. But when you actually be inside the ballot box, the voting booth, now you won and you got.
Really, now you won and you got. So now that moment day, now you actually did decide whether you want national development or not. Then let me believe. Me believe say we can talk all day do, but deep down we know the problem. We know the problem. So I'm unable to talk to you now. Yeah? I'm unable to talk on a radio. But we all deep down we know the problem to all these issues, all these solutions what they come up with. We know say if we or we self not do what we need for do, how can you expect the next man to do what he need for do? That is just a personal question where nobody no need for answer out loud. But if you say you want national development, you truly want national development, and then you see what we don't do so far in all the work, then how you be able to make a change as an individual, you on your own, how you be able to make a change today? The only way now, that way. The only way is that way. So the education we'll get for doing is so plenty, is so holistic. All man get for join and for making this education really so old. Me, I don't believe, see, the employee can talk, see, oh, Salomano, they change, Salomano, they change. I don't believe it for 1 second. And the example I go give is seatbelts. We've been touched on it very, very briefly earlier on. You're going to Sierra Leone today, I can guarantee you, many, many years, 3-4 years after the introduction of Sierra Leone, they make it along. You're going to Sierra Leone today, you're going to meet all my wearing seatbelts. Why? If you go inside taxi, you know where your seatbelt is inside less than 20 seconds. I guarantee you the driver, they mention it. If you don't mention it, so when inside the taxi, they mention it. One of the other passengers will mention it. Say, hey, where is your seatbelt to? Or matter where your seatbelt to. Now, why don't they walk? Well, Yusuf, you know, see, then they walk because if policeman catch you in a ticket, you know where your seatbelt is. It stops you. When it stops you, it takes something from you. Unfortunately, when it takes something from you for not wearing the seatbelt, that's something they need to go to some the consolidated fund where they run the country. They're going to demand in pockets. So, back to the same thing. Because the police man not make enough, you create an opportunity for journalist revenue on the fly, on the street, then begin implement this thing. In implementing this thing, even though now they very rarely then they do that too much because I guess all man they wear seatbelts, but in doing this thing, in doing it for their own selfish gains, Sierra Leoneans, their mentality change. And it changed overnight. Literally, it took about 2 weeks for that thing they hold in Sierra Leone, seatbelt law hold in Sierra Leone. So we get the capacity for change. We get the capacity of self-preservation because, you know, this thing is about self-preservation. Not for the Peter, that man all the time. See, some people now understand, not begin to understand the safety impact that it might save lives. You know, they hear about accidents. They say, oh, that person survived because he wears seatbelt. So slowly, it changes. It becomes something where they know they do now no more because policemen they stop. Because like I say, when we go to the zeal with which policemen they stop before, they know they stop so now. Because they tell them to this thing about 4 or 5 years ago, the roads they're not been done make like we can see what they're not intending. So now the flow of traffic, the speed which traffic they flows at sometimes. Some man, you know, they really get chance for the police stop and say, and see, you know, where it's. But it must stop for that thing, but you know, it's hard, you know, where it's because they flow so fast. But still, I tell you, when you go inside motor car, quick. Somebody either the driver or passenger don't tell you say hey, now for where you sit well. So if you know where I'm within a very short amount of time. What in that they tell we all now, Sierra Leoneans get the capacity for change. All we need for do is we or we serve as individuals, each one teach one, teach everybody for opening mind first. Let you understand, see, yes, we can change. Yeah, example of how we can change, and then try for changing mind about one thing. So if I summarize today, which we will left listeners with, is each one teach one. Just take one person and say, okay, these are the changing mind for learning, understand, see, in. Whatever it is you want to change in Sierra Leone. You just try with one person no more. If you succeed with the one, then who knows if now that one able to replicate what you do, how you teach and train able to get to that point where yourself understand. If yourself able to do one, I go with it go before so. Trust me, once you wait for the big thing they for happen, we the aim will impact 5 million people, 100,000 people, or 3,000 people in one school. Or to see the wait for that day, you get the resources for do all that one day, no matter where you are. Teach somebody, you can teach on the phone, you can teach on WhatsApp, you can teach on through social media, Facebook. Each one, teach one. Just teach somebody something. We they improve the country. Teach out for Wasian. You know, one person. Really, just one person. carry that one day. You know, my blog, it come up very soon on that. So people can report waiting and teach somebody this week or waiting and go like for teach somebody this week. It is very, 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 very important that we take on individual responsibility for national development. Don't be deterred. Don't be put off by thinking, no, I know me one not going to make a difference. Small, small, little drops of water. We all know the rest.
Thank you very much, Bolo. And I don't know what in are you scheduled for next week. I know we left him for long to see if we can come back and do the how part of the show. I don't know what in are you scheduled for next week, but we go discuss that if possible. Then we go continue the discussion next week.
This is a million part for national development. So I am ready, willing, and able. I just say next week, Saturday, go okay, same time.
Yes, definitely.
The listeners, they will not listen today, sorry. Let us get excited that we will continue this conversation next week. They say, put some now then diary. Put it in your diary, you know. Put some in your diary for say yes next week. Me say they can contribute to this conversation. And inside the week, maybe you're able to tell who that you don't teach something this week about whether it be what they go through with people them, whether it be that Tambawe say for abide the rule of law, Tambawe that you go don't talk to this week. Kemo, we talk about integrity from within, who that you go don't talk to this week. Bullman on the medical side, maybe not something, but Ebola, wash your hand, keep and clean. Cleaning equipment, Esther, Yusuf, we know you're an all-rounder, always with us, and Paul Mark, always with us. Talking about education, revenue collection. Waiting you go like for C. Me, just each one. Somebody teach somebody this week. Let we know what they do by next week. Let's see national development happening right in front of your faces.
Okay. Yes, Yusuf, waiting will be your last word.
The encouragement is change, positive change, very contagious. Everything else we were talking about, show, just as Bolo mentioned, if you get something you would, education of any kind, practical or written, if you get them, my treasure, nobody will ever take them from you. Nobody will ever take them away from you. The best thing about knowledge is once you get them, the best rewards you get from them, like if you pass them along, you see somebody put them into practice. So, Amen. Me, I'd encourage everybody, do the best you can every day. If we do something positive in our salon, just like you mentioned with the seatbelt, positive things are very contagious. It just takes a week. Then they will be able to translate them into any aspect of the life in our salon. If somebody acts good, trust me, something will be popular the first day or two, but it will catch up. I mean, I get a firm belief and I get faith in the people of salon.
Thank you very much, Yusuf.
Just imagine, Yusuf, truthfully, just imagine, look how Yusuf end up so. Imagine the number of lives we don't be saved by seatbelt wearing in Sierra Leone. Just imagine the number of lives we don't be saved in the last 4 or 5 years through people wearing seatbelts. So just try to quantify that and just think about it. And then think within their life, then they don't, in the subsequent years, we don't survive, we don't do for developed country, develop their own family, their own household, their own office, their own whatever, their own community. Just think of waiting on come out of that name. So what would they think of saving a life? You know, the impact, if we quantify them over 20 years, it's mind-blowing. So I'll stop on that note. Thank you very much again, AAA, for hosting. I appreciate your comments, Yusuf, and everybody else for taking part. I just look forward to seeing everybody next week, and I wish everybody a very prosperous week ahead.
Thank you very much, Bolo. Thank you very much, Yusuf. So next week we will go continue the conversation.
Absolutely. All right, God bless.
Thank you.